Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this video we'll be creating this Photoshop neon sign effect. Now if you enjoy this video, make sure you click the like button and also subscribe to my channel. If you want to learn a lot more about Photoshop, take a look at the links for my complete training, which you'll find in the description. Okay, let's get to it. Creating this Photoshop neon text effect is not that difficult to do, but it does require a few steps, and as you can see over here, several different layers. All right, let's start this whole project from the very beginning. I'm just going to close this one down, and we'll start off with a brand new file, File New. Now I'm using Photoshop CC 2017, which has this new document dialog box. If you're working in an earlier version of Photoshop, no problem. We're just using the default Photoshop size right there, which is 7 wide by 5 tall, landscape or horizontal mode, and a resolution of 300 pixels per inch. Choose Create. There we go. Let's just make this fit the page. There it is, fit page. Now we need to bring in our bricks. Go up to File, come down to Place Embedded, and here's my brick picture. Now there's a link for this. I have a material support page for this video, and you'll find all the links on that page, and the link for that page is of course in the description. Go ahead and place that. There we are. Now it's a little bit too skinny, as you can see. I'm just going to stretch this out to reach the sides, just like that. There we are. Click on the check, and that's in place. Now I want this darker, moodier looking, a bit more interesting looking, and that requires just a few steps to get the background just exactly right. We'll start off with taking the red brick layer, drag it down to the new layer button, and that gives us a copy. Let's now blend the copy into the original using one of our blend modes over here. Now if you come down, there is a linear burn layer right there. These are all the darken modes, and here you want the linear burn. That darkens it down, kind of makes the colors richer, and they look a little bit glossier at the same time. Really makes the wall look nice, gives it a real kind of nice artistic effect. Now I want to also have the corners darken down in here. Let's darken our corners down. We'll do that on the bottom of our brick layers. Go up to Filter and Lens Correction. And in here, here's our Lens Correction dialog box. Let me see if I can get this thing to fit properly. There we go. Now I can see it. And here over on Custom, what you want is the vignette right down there, vignette. It's lightened on the right, darkened on the left. Just take this and go clear to the left on that, clear it all the way to darken. It just darkens down the corners. Choose OK. And that just gives us a real nice moody effect. Now overall the picture is still too bright, the bricks are still too bright. We need to darken the whole thing down a little bit. So back up here to our top layer, make a new layer above that. Make sure that your foreground color is black. Just click on the reset button right there. Foreground color is black. Grab the paint bucket and just fill that. Or you can do a layer and new fill layer, solid color, and fill it with black. Either way works just fine. So a black layer. Obviously we need to see our bricks. So let's bring down the opacity on this a bit until I can see the bricks. And I have mine set at 40%. It's fairly dark, but that's what you want because our lettering will be bright on top of this. This needs to be darkened in the background. The nice thing about doing it this way is that I can always change my opacity to a different setting if I'm not quite happy with the look of this. Once everything else is finished, I can then just kind of, you know, adjust the opacity to get this exactly right. But there it is. There is the background for the text. We're now ready to add the type onto the page. So let's go to our text tool right here. There we are. And the typeface I'm using is called That's Font Folks. Nice, real simple script. The nice thing about this is that all the lettering is exactly the same thickness clear throughout. Now you'll find a link to download this typeface also on my video support page, and the link for that, of course, is in the description. I have this set at 140 points, and it's set at sharp, centered, and set the color here at white. Just drag upper left hand corner like that, choose OK, and it's white. Alright, come down about a third of the way down to the page, click in here, and let's put in our text. Dance Studio, just like that. I'm going to bring this over a little bit. One, two, three, four. And we need to adjust the spacing on this so the spacing is a bit better. I'm just going to select both of those. There we are. Let's click this button right here. Brings up the character dialog box. And we can adjust the spacing right here. Just come right over where the double A's are, and if you pull to the left, it makes your spacing less, your line spacing left. Pull to the right, it increases your line spacing, just like that. So you can adjust the line spacing to suit, or just type it in. Now the one that I'm using is, let me just back up a little bit here. There we go. 130 for the line spacing. It's just a little bit closer together. Okay, there's our Dance Studio basic text. We now can double click on character and close that down. We're done with that. You can take this and just kind of position it about centered on the page. And it looks like right about, there's exactly centered, and let's see if we can find that. Right there, there we go. Exactly centered. Those pink lines popping up, those are the dynamic guides that show up here inside of Photoshop CC 2017. Very useful if you're positioning things on a page. Okay, I think I'm going to put it just a little bit higher than that, though. Feels a little low. There we go. Okay, there's Dance Studio. Now we're basing everything on this, and I want to now make our inner glow. Now to do the inner glow, we'll be grabbing a part of this, inner part of this, and making a new layer from the inner part. To do that, though, we need to have this layer rasterized. Now in case I want to change the text later on, have it say something else, I'm going to make a copy of this. Let's just drag it down here to the new layer button, make a copy of that, hide the original, and let's now rasterize this layer. Just right click on the name and rasterize type. There we are. Now this weird space in here, Dance Space Studio, that's those four spaces that we typed in up here just to move Studio over a little bit. Okay, now let's give this a little bit of a rotation, just a touch. If we do the Control T keyboard shortcut, brings up our bounding box, and then up here there's the angle, and I want this to rotate to the left, and that's a negative rotation, and then just 10. So it's a negative 10, rotates to the left just a little bit like that, and then choose OK, little check mark. All right, there we go. There's our basic rotation. We have our rasterized layer. We're all set to go. Let's now select just the text. Hold the Control key down or Command on the Mac. Click on the thumbnail for the layer, and that selects the contents of the thumbnail, which in this case is the type. We're now going to modify this and shrink this down so it's a lot smaller. Go up here to Select, come down to Modify, and Contract. And I have mine set to contract by 10 pixels. Choose OK. That just squeezes it in like that. So there it is, squeezed in. So just the middle section is now selected. Now here's where we had to have this layer rasterized. I'm going to copy this to a new layer. Go up to the layer menu, come down to new, and layer via copy. And there it is. If I hide the other one, there's our middle part, and we'll use that for the highlight. So I'll just go ahead and rename the layer. And make sure I type that right. There we go. Neon highlight. Okay, we're now ready for some coloration. Come back to our main layer here, our main text layer, and we'll be doing our coloration and all of our effects with the layer styles. Come down to the FX button, brings up our layer styles. The first thing to do here is the color overlay. We'll be adding color onto that. And the color I'm using is already sitting in here. And it's FD4AFF. So that's FD4AFF. It's just a nice bright magenta. This full magenta is over here. Go to the left a little bit, it brightens it up a little bit as we go towards the white side. So it's a nice bright magenta, and choose OK. And now you can see that right there. Here's our nice magenta around the lettering. Okay, that's the basic coloration for that. We now see that the white is too hard, it's too stiff, has a real hard edge. We need to fix that hard edge. So go back up to our neon highlight layer. We're going to soften down the edge of this with the Gaussian blur filter. So go up to filter, come down to blur, and then Gaussian blur right there. Here we go. Now if I pull this way over, so it's pretty low down here, there's a 1.2. As I pull it up, you'll see that the white begins to soften out, begins to soften down. If I go too far, it goes away. So somewhere down in here is a pretty good range for that. Now what I used was 5. I set mine at 5. So there it is without hard edge, and there it is with just kind of a soft edge. But we still have some nice white areas in there. So that takes care of the blurring of that edge. Now it's still too bright on this. You may like that, it's up to you. I think it should be a little bit quieter than this, a bit too much. So we'll adjust the opacity of our layer here. I'm going to bring my opacity down to 75%. And the nice thing about doing it this way again, just like our black layer, is I can go back and I can adjust the opacity later on if I'm not happy with the look. I can always bring that opacity up a little bit to make the white brighter on that. So there we go. There's the basic lettering in place. Let's now work on the glow. There are two parts of the glow, glowing around the letters and then a glow on the wall in behind. Let's draw our letters first. Come down to our main text layer, double click on effects. Brings up our layer style dialog box again. Come down to outer glow. There we are, outer glow. And that gives us a nice glow around the lettering, as you can see right down here. Now the color is the same. We kept the color the same on this one. And I have the blend mode set at screen, opacity set at 80%, so it's not quite full 100% in there. And the spread is at 7% and the size at 43%. These are the settings from when I did this for the initial example on that. So there's the settings for that glow. Here it is without the glow. And there it is with. So again, that's outer glow, screen, opacity of 80, same color as the text. And again, that is the FD4 AFF. And Technique Softer, spread 7% and size 43 pixels. Choose OK. So there's the glowing for the lettering. We now can work on the wall in behind this. Now a little bit tricky on this one. We're still on our lettering layer here. Hold the Control key down or Command if you're on a Mac and click on the thumbnail for that layer. That selects the text right there. Let's now come down to the black layer. Make a new layer above that. Here's our new layer above that. And we'll do our background glow on this layer. So let's just expand this selection. Go up to Select, come down to Modify, and Expand. Let's expand this by 50 pixels. Choose OK. Just makes a big, large selection like that way outside, and that's going to be the basis for our glow. Now we're on our background here, you know, above our background layers and below the text layers on our new layer. Let's set a different color here. Click on your foreground colors. Now I want this to be in the same range but darker than what we had for the lettering. Now the actual color that I used down here is a C102C3. It's from the same color family as the lettering, but full saturation and darker. So there we go. Choose OK. Now to take the paint bucket, click into that selection, and that fills that. You can see how it's in behind. It's darker than the rest of the lettering. That's fine. We can now get rid of that selection. Go up to Select and Deselect. Now obviously it's too hard of an edge and it's too solid. We need to fix those two problems. Let's do the hard edge first, again with the Gaussian blur. Go up to Filter, come down to Blur and Gaussian blur. It's still sitting at the 5 that we just used. We need to have this much higher. As I pull it up, you'll see that it begins to blur out that background. Now what I liked was a setting of 60 on the Gaussian blur. If you go too far, it gets too large in there. If you're not far enough, you still have an edge showing. So I found for me 60 seems to work out just fine. Choose OK. But we also need to have this blend into the wall in the back. It doesn't look like it's actually lighting up the wall yet. So let's take care of that. And that again is with a blend mode. So back to our blend modes right here. And this time we're going to come way down here to our lighten section and use linear light. And there it is. It lights up that wall and it looks just like the neon lighting is actually lighting the wall up and colorizing the wall at the same time. And there we go. There is the Photoshop neon sign text effect. Pretty easy, as you can see, once it's been done, once we've gone through all the steps, but there are just a few steps to do. Now, as I mentioned before, at this point, you can adjust the black layer if you want to. If you think the wall's too dark or too light, you can adjust that by adjusting your opacity. And you can adjust the highlight right now on the highlight layer, again, by adjusting your opacity. I think they look nice, but we do have those two layers are set to easily adjust in here, so it gives you some control over that final look. But there we go. That is how to do the Photoshop neon text effect. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you found it useful. If you like this video, click on the like button below to let others know. You can click the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. I'm frequently uploading new training videos. Don't forget to check out my website at howtogurus.com.